Neighbours, rivals, often enemies. Before the Act of Union, there was England and there was Scotland. As the age of empire dawned, both nations set sail to conquer the world. England found fertile territory in Virginia, but Scotland's imperial ambitions died after an ill-fated colonial adventure in Panama. After its failure in the New World, Scotland turned to the old enemy, and the Union was born. Although Scotland entered into the Union from a position of weakness, the two nations united as equals, and the United Kingdom went on to dominate the globe. The British Empire turned the map pink, and everywhere the British Empire went, Scots were in the vanguard. In India, by 1792, Scots made up 1 in 9 civil servants and 1 in 3 army officers. 7 of India's 12 viceroys were Scottish. Glasgow built the ships that ruled the waves for Britannia. But as the imperial tide turned, and as Britain's colonies one by one sought independence, some in Scotland also began to question their continued membership of the Union. Far from seeing themselves as fellow colonialists, they felt themselves to be living in England's closest colony. By joining its lot with England, Scotland created the idea of the United Kingdom. If Scots vote yes on Thursday, without the tether of the original Act of Union, could other parts of the British Isles feel their ties to the Union also begin to loosen?